Did you know that you can use this to provide frost protection for your young, tender plants? Hi, I'm Kylene, and I'm the Provident Prepper. I have something really cool to show you today. So these are just water cooler bottles, right? The kind that you use in the offices or when you have water delivered. But we found a way to use them to protect our tender plants. In our area, our last frost date is a good month past where we could be growing really good, healthy plants, but then we have that one late frost that just kills everything. So we decided we'd start using these to protect some of our tender plants. Now, what we did is you can purchase these and they're, you know, $8 a piece or so, but we actually called the manufacturing company and asked them, or a local water bottle distribution place, and asked them if we could buy some, or if they had some that were old or damaged. And we learned that they actually recycle them every 5 or 6 uses, and they melt them down and they remake them. So they were incredibly generous, and they just let us have a bunch of these bottles. We probably have 20 or 30 of them. The one drawback to them that I have discovered is that they don't store well. It takes a lot of room to store this. And if you store them outside, they will degrade, but they also get wasps in them. So you really need to have a decent location to store them, someplace where they're indoors. But Jonathan just cut off the bottom of these bottles, and then we put them over the plants. Now, some of the plants, these are gonna blow away, right? So depending on where the plant is, we'll put a stake down the center or a big stick so that it can't blow away. And that tends to work really well. For these plants, we do something just a little bit different. I love just putting this stake under it, and I pull that out, and then I'm able to just drop it over the plants. And then the next morning, I just pull the jug back up, put the stake under here, and I can leave it for a week or two without any problem or damage to the plant. And yet it's super slick when we have a frost warning just to come and pull out all these stakes and drop them on the plants. One of the keys that make this work so well is this ventilation at the top of the bottle. Plants can get cooked really quickly and really easily if they don't have adequate ventilation. And this is just perfect. Even in the hard frosts, I never cover this top. It doesn't seem to affect the plant at all if this top is open. It's kind of like the winter sown method that we've shown you before, where you're planting the seedlings in the milk jugs. Actually, click the card in the corner and I'll take you to a video that will explain that a little bit. But this ventilation is really important. And the plastic just seems to be enough that it keeps the really cold out and it protects the plant. And yet, if you need to leave it on for several days, there's plenty of sunshine that gets through and it protects the plant from the harsh winds also. But the outside environment, I really like to get my plants acclimated to that. So whenever the weather is good, I always lift it off the plant so that it has an opportunity to become hardened off and acclimated and be strong because of the winds. This is just one more fun method that we found to be able to extend our growing season, which makes a huge difference when you're depending on your garden to feed your family. One of the best things about this method for me was that it was free. It didn't cost us anything except for some gas to drive up and to get them. And there are several other things that you can do on a very low budget to protect your plants. Just turning one of the black pots upside down on top of your plant will help to keep it warm and safe and protected. A lot of times I'll put a rock on top. Clay pots work really well. Just kind of be willing to experiment and see what will work for you. But remember, ventilation makes a huge difference. The plant just has to be able to breathe in order to survive. And now for the question of the day. What tips or tricks can you share with us about how you keep your plants from freezing so that you can extend your growing season? Comment below. And thanks for being part of the solution.